Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be going to explain you NB-IoT, Narrowband Internet of Things. Let me show you outlines of this video first. So in this video, first I'll be discussing about basics of NB-IoT. Then I'll explain you how NB-IoT functions. Then I'll show you basic architecture of NB-IoT. Then I'll explain you basic applications of NB-IoT. And at last, I'll be discussing about advantages of NB-IoT. So let us start this session with first agenda, that is basics of NB-IoT. See, NB-IoT means what? It is narrowband internet of things. So here devices will be communicating with narrow bandwidth, and as narrow bandwidth is there, those devices are functioning at low power. So NB-IoT, that is using low power wide area network, that is also referred as LPWAN. So NB-IoT, that is using low power wide area network. That wide area network that is created with the use of cellular network, and devices will be functioning at lower power, right? See, NB-IoT that was developed by third generation partnership project 3GPP for wireless cellular network. So in NB-IoT, devices are communicating with the use of wireless cellular network, in which GSM channels as well as unused LTE channels are occupied. So in wireless cellular network with NB-IoT, we are having GSM channels and unused LTE channels for communication with device. So devices with Internet of Things with NB-IoT are using wireless channels with wireless cellular network, where channels are there from GSM as well as it can be there from unused LTE channel. How it is occupied, that even I'll explain you in working in this video itself. See, NB-IoT devices can have battery life for more than 10 years. Why battery life is that huge? The reason is NB-IoT devices are functioning at narrowband, so it consumes very less power. And as it is consuming very less power, you will be observing battery life of NB-IoT devices that is quite huge. It is there beyond 10 years, right? See, NB-IoT works with narrowband, so it works with low power, and it can be used in cost-effective IoT applications, where latency is allowed up to 1.6 to 10 seconds for transmission. See, these NB-IoT devices are working with narrowband and low cost applications, where transmission delay or transmission latency, that is ranging somewhere from 1.6 seconds to 10 seconds, right? Transmission time means it is a time required for communication from device to application center, right? So it is around 1.6 to 10 seconds. That's why one can say it is there for low cost application. We are not using it for real time applications. See, NB-IoT, that is using radio band of 200 kilohertz, and NB-IoT is working with LPWAN, low power wide area network. With LPWAN, there are some other examples even like LoRaWAN and Sigfox. In my next video, I'll be going to explain you LoRaWAN, long range wide area network, right? See, LoRaWAN, that is not operated with cellular channels. Here NB-IoT, that is operating with GSM or unused LTE channels. LoRaWAN, that is having wireless network, but it is not using channels which are there in cellular network, right? Now I'll be explaining you how working is there with NB-IoT. See, as I have told you, NB-IoT is operating at licensed mobile carrier network. One should know, see, mobile carrier network that is having frequencies, those are licensed one. Here with NB-IoT, we are having GSM channel as well as LTE channels. Let us try to understand first how those channels are occupied over here. So here, see, LTE carrier is there, means LTE bands are there, in which first let me explain you how in-band operation happens. See, with LTE carrier, as if LT channel is free, then NB-IoT devices can use that channel for communication. Means it is in-band operation. In second case, you see here I have shown guard band operation. Guard band operation means in between channels, there is unused frequency space. So NB-IoT can functions at that guard band even. The reason is NB-IoT is having narrow band communication. So that guard band even can be occupied here. And see, that will be occupied as if LT and GSM channels are busy. And this NB-IoT that can operate in GSM channels as well, right? So here you can observe various GSM channels are there, right? And as if GSM channel is free, then NB-IoT can operate at GSM channels even, right? So that is how there are three ways by which NB-IoT devices can communicate, right? See, NB-IoT is using QPSK digital modulation scheme, that is quadrature phase shifting modulation scheme, right? Here for uplink, NB-IoT is using FDMA, and for downlink it is using orthogonal FDMA. FDMA means frequency division multiple axis. See, NB-IoT module comes with sensors, actuators, antenna and chipset. So here modules will be communicating with base station, right? So with that module, sensors are there for sensing physical parameters, actuators are there for giving physical response, antenna is there for a communication over LTE or GSM carriers. Here we are communicating with base station of mobile center, right? So for that you need to have antenna, and there will be chipset integrated with module, right? So that is how complete module will be there with NB-IoT devices. Now I'll explain you basic architecture of NB-IoT. If you observe basic architecture of NB-IoT, then here we are having NB-IoT device. I have told you that device is having how many things? Sensors, actuators, chipset and antenna. With the use of antenna, it can communicate with base station. But if you observe here, it is mentioned that it is NIDD compatible device. Means it is non-IP data supported device, right? So here non-IP data communication that will happen with this base station, right? Here there is no IP required for data communication. One should know, in computer networks, when you want to have logical routing, means addressing, at that time you need to have IP address. But here these devices are communicating with base station of cellular network, where that communication will be based on non-IP based communication. That data will go to core network equipment. So up to this communication, there will be no IP requirement. Once that data goes into core network equipment, that data will be forwarded on internet. And to forward data on internet, now there will be IP configuration with that data. And see, in internet, there will be IoT platforms, right? With the use of IoT platforms, one can develop many applications, and those applications can be used by users, right? So here in NB-IoT architecture, you'll be observing, see, when device is communicating with base station, so that is non-IP based communication. And once that base station is forwarding data to core network equipment, after that, that data will go on internet. And once data goes on internet, IoT platforms will be utilizing it. So this communication will be based on IP addressing, right? And entire application will be end-to-end secured one, right? So that is how basic architecture is there. Now, let us try to understand how many applications are there with NB-IoT. So first one is smart lighting. So on street light also, these applications can be implemented. Here, smart metering is also one of that application. Like for light bill, you can have smart metering. For gas bill, you can have smart metering with the use of NB-IoT. See, one can have this NB-IoT for asset management. We can have it for smart parking. We can have it for water conservation, and we can use this for alarms and event detector. So that is how varieties of applications are there. You can say for multi-node mobile based architecture, one can have as many applications as possible. For smart cities, NB-IoT is very useful. Right now in 2023, around 1 billion devices are there. Those are using NB-IoT applications, right? As if you talk about advantages of NB-IoT, then one should know we can use NB-IoT for high density network. Cellular network is already high density network. Here, NB-IoT devices are only using channels of cellular network, where we can have high density network. See, for low power consumption, we are using this. And as I have told you, these devices are having battery life for more than 10 years. So that is happening because of low power consumption, right? See, higher data rates can be achieved. You cannot say huge data rate. Here we can have up to 200 kbps data rate speed with NB-IoT, and for low cost application, this data rate is sufficient, right? See, we can have lower cost application with NB-IoT. We can have low bandwidth applications based on NB-IoT, and we can have extended coverage with NB-IoT. Extended coverage is happening because of cellular network. Right now in the entire globe, humongous cellular network is already spreaded. And if IoT is occupying that with the use of NB-IoT, then one can have so many applications, so many devices can be connected with the use of cellular network, right? So that is how varieties of advantages are there with NB-IoT. I hope you have understood this session. Still, if anything that you like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.